Hello, my dear friends. I'm very glad to see you on my channel. I'm Maria. And today we are in Ясная Поляна. It's in Tula region. Everybody knows Leo Tolstoy, our famous writer, and his War and Peace. So we came here to see where he lived and where he spent all his life.
In Ясная Поляна, Tolstoy was born. He wrote War and Peace and Anna Karenina here, and he is buried here. The museum contains Tolstoy's personal effects and movables, as well as his library of 22,000 volumes. The Volkonsky house, where Tolstoy's grandfather Nikolai lived, is the oldest structure on the estate. During Tolstoy's time, it was the home for servants. Later, the east wing of the house became the studio of Tolstoy's daughter Tatiana, who was a painter. And in front of Volkonsky house, there is a stable. Up to a ripe old age, Tolstoy loved horseback riding. He did it almost every day before dinner. Tolstoy had a real delight, especially when he rode on his favorite horse, whose name was Delir. It's really cold now, that's why no people here. But in some of my friends there is no room to speak here. By the way, War and Peace has over 400,000 words. Tolstoy was an anarchist. Not just an anarchist, Tolstoy's reputation is as a Christian anarchist. It was certainly a revolutionary concept in Tsarist Russia. As a Christian, he considered it necessary to be a pacifist. He believed the state to be the greatest contributor to war and murder, so therefore the state had to be disregarded. Tolstoy was watched by the Russian secret police. Not much of a surprise here, considering we learned that he was anti-government. Yet it wasn't only his confrontation with the secular Tsarist government that brought the secret police to rain down on him. And this is Tolstoy's house. The house of Leo Tolstoy had originally been a wing of the largest house, built by Tolstoy's father, where Tolstoy was born. Tolstoy was forced to sell the main part of the old house, which was dismantled and moved to another estate. The house today is kept as it appeared when he died in 1910. I don't know why, but it's the most popular place here. Tolstoy died of pneumonia in Ostapovo train station. After wandering like the ascetic he was, the author was brought upstairs to die after being treated with morphine and camphor. He died at a train station where famously his character Anna Karenina came to her end. Still, it's almost fitting that the author and his character were somehow linked in the end. And today only the true fans of literature came to Ясная Поляна. And so, apparently, is one of them. Let's talk to her.
Девушка, стойте, можно вас на секундочку? Здравствуйте. Мы делаем видео для иностранных зрителей. Можно вам несколько вопросов задать?
А, да, конечно.
Как вас зовут?
Женя.
Женя, откуда вы сюда приехали, в Ясную Поляну?
Я живу в Туле, здесь недалеко, в моем родном городе.
Вы здесь часто бываете?
Периодически, где-то, может быть, раз в два года. Особенно красиво здесь весной очень.
А что вы можете вообще рассказать о России для наших зрителей?
Россия, ну это моя родная страна. Страна, которая не может не вызывать восторг и восхищение с огромной, очень мощной древней культурой, интересной. К сожалению, в последнее время происходит не очень радостные события в нашей стране. Это не может меня не расстраивать, как человека, который живет в этой стране. Хотелось бы, чтобы мы были более дружны со всеми остальными странами.
Ну, мы будем надеяться, что скоро у нас все станет хорошо, как нам обещает наш президент. Спасибо вам большое, удачи, хороших выходных.
Счастливо.
До свидания.
It's a tradition of the locals to come here for a walk on their wedding day. Only real desperate Russian women can walk in a wedding dress when it's 10 degrees under zero. May you live happily ever after, guys.